This time we're going to talk about you losing your chance to be ombudsman. You said on this show that it was honestly a dream, right? No, it was Harry Roque actually said it was his dream. Then if Kalida didn't want it, so he didn't even apply. But then you were excluded from the JBC shortlist. Yeah. Okay, I want to ask you, do you feel it was unfair that the JBC excluded you from the shortlist?
As to their choice, Karen, hindi siguro. Kasi, okay, in fairness, yung naman mga ni-recommend nila as nominees, okay naman.
Okay ka.
But as to the process, mukhang
why? Okay.
Nakaligtaan nila. Unang-una.
Okay. Because they said you had pending cases
yes,
with the DOJ,
yes,
plus you have this affidavit and accusation against you.
Yes.
But we'll start first that they said your pending cases with the DOJ excluded
yes,
you.
Yes. Unang-una, my first question is, if I had that case, why did you let me go through the process of being interviewed by
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
Pinaasa pa ninyo ako.
So do you think you were politicized?
I don't know. I always want to give them the benefit of the doubt. Pangalawa, why did they not confront me about the case? They would have found out that case was pending, was filed as early as 2012. And they would have found out that I was charged for syndicated estafa as chairman of the board. And we submitted our counter affidavit. I gave them a copy. I had to go to SEC to get a copy of the articles of incorporation of that alleged corporation.
Yeah.
I'm not a member of the board, and I'm not the chairman of the board. So we filed our counter affidavit 2012. When we found out it is still pending investigation.
Okay. All right. So that's one, but I want to ask this before we go because we really concentrated on labor. All right, there's an extortion complaint filed against the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission by a certain Ali Dizon of the Kilusang Pagbabago National Movement for Change. And she alleges that you had full knowledge of the 6.8 million pesos being extorted from Aziza Manpower Corporation. It's an overseas Filipino company. You knew about it, she says, and supposedly it was Adole Undersecretary Dominador Sai who asked for the 6.8 million pesos. Okay, the irony is she first went to your Undersecretary Jing Paras, who accepted the case, technically, under the PACC.
Well, yung complaint natin is ito si Dizon.
Okay.
Very clear that even just on the basis of that alleged affidavit, anong liability ko dyan? Kung may tumanggap, anong liability ko?
Oh, tinanggap ba ni Yusek Dominador sa?
I don't know.
He resigned, right?
I'm not aware of that transaction.
Okay,
in
but
fact,
he resigned.
Talking about Ms. Aziza Salin, this is the lady that was brought by Mr. Paras to the president. And she related the alleged extortion to the president. And after that, they prepared an affidavit which they asked her to sign. And she willingly signed.
Okay, but if your Undersecretary Jing Paras brought that lady directly to the president, it's easy to deduce that he wants you out of your job.
I don't know. I don't know his intention.
Because why would he take the person to the president instead of tell you about it, that there are these accusations against you? My question is, Jing Paras is still your USEC.
Yes.
How could you work with him?
Well, he has his job to do. I have my job to do. I don't mind kung ano mga panaginip niya sa buhay. I don't care kung ano. If he wants my position, all he has to do is ask it from me.
Yeah,